The war had by now turned against England. The French were ravaging the English coast. The shrunken working population demanded proper wages. They had no interest in performing feudal duties on the land, while desperate landowners needed more than ever to enforce them. Gaunt's government needed money and tried to raise it from a poll tax, not understanding that the population was far smaller than before. When they failed to raise the money they'd expected, they tried again, and England erupted. Lords, nobles, bishops, get rid of them all! Who needs them? When Adam delved and Eve span, who was then the gentleman? The so-called Peasants' Revolt of 1381 was actually an uprising of the respectable people of towns and villages across England. Its aim, at least for the rebels that captured London, was an end to lordship in church and state. Just one archbishop and a king. Specifically not, they added, a king called John. They detested John of Gaunt, who went into hiding. The dramatic moment, of course, was the meeting of Richard and the rebels at Smithfield on the 14th of June. The rebel leader, Wat Tyler, was talking to the king when the mayor of London cut him down. The rebels immediately drew their bows, and the king, now 14 years old, rode forward to calm them.
I will be your captain. Come with me into the fields and you shall have all you ask.
And they dispersed as he told them. It was an astonishing lesson in the mysterious power of kingship. The rebels should never have trusted him, of course. Once the danger was past, the ringleaders were hunted down and killed. Villains ye are, and villains ye shall remain. Years later, when Richard would need popular support, he would find he had none. But Richard had been given a dramatic vision of himself. He seems to have been convinced that the basis of his power lay in the special authority of sovereignty. He was the first English king to have portraits made. Instead of wars, he offered tournaments accompanied by music and dancing with the ladies of the court. But Richard's choice of companions were not the kind of men that most barons approved of. And above all, Richard abandoned the war with France, leaving France in control of Flanders. Unpleasant references were made to Edward II, and look what happened to him. He found himself up against a group of noblemen who called themselves the Lord's Appellant, appealing to have his closest advisers removed and take over the government, which is what happened. Richard was effectively dethroned. He was able to recover power in 1397. As part of his efforts to secure his throne, he exiled Henry Bolingbroke, John of Gaunt's son. But Bolingbroke came back with a vengeance, and Richard found that wherever he turned for support, it simply wasn't there. Bolingbroke captured him, demanded his voluntary abdication, and then sat on his throne. Richard disappeared into a prison in Pontefract Castle, where he was murdered. Richard had no children. The line of the Black Prince, Edward III's eldest son, had come to an end.